This is a common select statement. When you run this kind of statement, MySQL returns the columns in the order that they are defined in the base table. If that is not what you want, you can use the order by clause to specify the sort order for the rows in a result set. The order by clause specifies the sort order for the rows in a result set. This example shows an order by clause that sorts by the first name column in ascending sequence. Note the use of this keyword. Since ascending is the default, this keyword can be omitted. Therefore, those two statements are identical. In this example, the rows are sorted by the first name column in descending sequence. Note the use of this keyword. This example shows an order by clause that sorts by three columns. To sort by more than one column, you simply list the names in the order by clause separated by commas. As you can see from this example, you can sort by any column in the base table regardless of whether it is included in the select clause. This can be referred to as a nested sort because one sort is nested within another. Here, the rows in the names table are first sorted by the first name column in ascending sequence. Then, within each first name, the rows are sorted by the middle name column in descending sequence. Finally, within each middle name, the rows are sorted by the last name column in ascending sequence. The result set only contains the last name column because it's the only one that you requested in the select clause. This is an ordered by clause that uses an alias. The ordered by clause can include a column alias that's specified in the select clause, if the column alias does not include spaces. This select statement, for example, sorts by a column named customer due, which is an alias for this operation. The ordered by clause can include any valid expression. This expression can refer to any column in the base table, even if it is not included in the result set, as shown by this example. Here, the expression consists of this operation. Notice that neither of these columns is included in the select clause. Although MySQL allows this coding technique, many other SQL dialects don't. Let's have a look at this statement. In an order by clause, you can use column numbers to specify a sort order. Let's have a look at it. To use this technique, you code the number that corresponds to the column of the result set, where 1 is the first column, 2 is the second column, and so on. In this example, the order by clause sorts the result set by the first column, which contains the first name column, then by the second column in the ascending sequence, which contains the middle name column, and then by the third column, which contains the last name column. Note that the statement that uses column numbers is more difficult to read because you have to look at the select clause to see what columns in the numbers refer to. In addition, if you add or remove columns from the select clause, you may also have to change the order by clause to reflect the new column positions. As a result, you should avoid using this technique in most situations. Let's rewrite this statement with column names instead of numbers. Let's see now how does the ordered by clause behave with special characters and numbers. For this purpose, we take the specials table, which contains letters, numbers, special symbols, and null values all together. By default, in an ascending sort, special characters appear first in the sort sequence, followed by numbers, then letters. Null values appear first in the sort sequence. In a descending sort, letters appear first in the sort sequence, followed by numbers, then special characters. Null values appear last in the sort sequence.